Hello, I'm Bob.
Hello, I'm Hannah, and we are Kitchen Zoo. And today, we're going to do some baking and some making ready for our story of the gingerbread skeleton.
Today, I'm going to show you how to make some vampire bat puppets.
And I'm going to show you how to bake some gingerbread skeletons.
First of all, we're going to do some baking. So I need to wash my hands and put my apron on. I'll be right back. I've washed my hands and I've got my apron, so I'm ready.
To make your gingerbread skeletons, you will need flour, golden syrup, light brown sugar, bicarbonate of soda, ground ginger, unsalted butter, an egg, a bowl, a rolling pin, a spoon, and either a cutter or a knife.
You're going to need an adult to turn the oven on for you to 180 degrees. And we're going to need to prepare some baking trays ready for our gingerbread biscuits. So you can either use baking parchment, if you've got it, or some non-stick mats.
In this bowl, I've put 125 grams of plain flour, 5 grams of bicarbonate of soda, 15 grams of ground ginger, and now I'm going to add 120 grams of cold butter, and I'm going to crumble it together using my hands until it resembles fine breadcrumbs.
Hannah, don't forget to put the sugar in.
Oh, thanks, Bob. Good thinking. I'm going to add 175 grams of light brown sugar and give it a really good stir.
Into this mixture, I'm going to add one egg. And 5 tablespoons of golden syrup. Beat it all together.
So we've made our dough. If it's not sticking together, you might need to add a bit more golden syrup. I did, and it tastes extra yummy. Now we're going to roll it out until it's about 0.5 centimetre thick, or as thick as a pound coin.
So now I'm going to use my cutout of a gingerbread person, lay it on. I might need an adult to help me. Cut round it carefully with a knife. Now you might have a gingerbread person cutter at home and you could use that, but I'm just going to use this. I'm going to put my first tray of gingerbread people into the oven while I make the rest.
Oh, they smell lovely.
Now you'll need an adult to help you get them out of the oven. Don't forget your oven gloves and put them on one side to cool.
While my biscuits are cooling down, I'm going to get some icing ready.
I've mixed together in this bowl some icing sugar and a little bit of water.
Once you've made your icing and it's nice and thick, you need to put it in a piping bag. And if you haven't got a piping bag, you could use some paper, some baking paper would work. You use 0.5 circle. You're going to twist it round until you have a nice funnel shape. There we go. And then put a little piece of sellotape on one end. There we go. That's going to be my piping bag. My icing can go in the top, and then there'll be a tiny hole at the bottom where it'll come out.
I'm going to pipe some eyes and a skeleton mouth. And this is some ribs.
It's quite fiddly. Some long leg bones. And then two arms.
That looks really good. Smells good too.
So these are my finished gingerbread skeletons. Now I'm sure it'd be all right to eat some of them, but I'm going to keep one or two for our story this week because I think I might need them.
Ooh.
Oh, Bob, how did you make this bat puppet?
It's brilliant.
To make your bat puppets, you will need a pencil, some scissors, a needle and thread, some white paper, and some black paper or any colour you like. Pumpkin optional. First, start by drawing your bat. I draw a semicircle and some dots where the bat's wings will be. And then I join the dots with some curvy lines. Then give your bat some ears. This is your template. The next thing to do is cut it out. Once you've cut your bat out, that is your template, and you might need a grown-up to help you cut it out. Now you can use your bat to draw around on your coloured paper. And now you can make as many bats as you like. I'm going to do 6. And then get a grown-up to help you cut your bat out of your coloured paper. Once you've cut out your bat, and I've given mine a little expression, some eyes and some vampire fangs, and I've done that with a white crayon, then you get your needle and thread, and you might need a grown-up to help you do this. You poke a little hole and pull the thread through. And then we're going to tie the ends of the thread together. There we go. And there you have a bat.
These bats are absolutely batty. Ooh, you could use them as decorations as well when you've finished.
Well, I hope you enjoyed making vampire bat puppets, and remember, you'll need some of these and a delicious gingerbread skeleton for our story next week. See you then.
See you later. Bye.